So consider source and listener move towards with velocity that V by 10. So both source and listener move towards with certain velocity, that is velocity of sound V, that is V by 10. So 1 by 10th of V. Then the frequency created by the source is F. Then what is the frequency heard by the listener? So n dash is equal to what? So here source and listener move towards. So we know the formula. So this is the first case one. So V plus VL by V minus VS. So we know that VL and VS is same. That is 1 by 10th of V. So that V is the velocity of sound. So we no need of that values. Just we can do the problem directly. So just substitute instead of VL and VS, V by 10. So here V plus V by 10, V minus V by 10. So just cross. So 10V plus V by 10, 10V minus V by 10. So 10 plus 1, 11V. So 10 minus 1, 9V. So 11V by 10, 9V by 10. So just substitute that N is equal to just the given F. So just rearrange. So 11V by 10. So then goes to numerator. So 10 by 9. So that 10, 10 cancel, that V, V cancel. You will get 11 by 9 times F. So 1 9s are 9, balance 220. So 2 9s are 18, again balance. So 1.22 F. So here N dash is greater than N. So the frequency heard by the listener is greater than the frequency created by the source. So there is a doubler effect here. Then here listener is at rest. So at what frequency, so at what velocity the velocity of source moves away from the listener when the frequency heard by the listener is half of the frequency created by the source. So they have given that n dash is equal to n by 2. So frequency heard by the listener is, that is n dash, is equal to half of the frequency created by the source. So at what velocity the velocity of source moves away. So just compare here. So here listener is at rest, no problem. Here velocity, that is that source moves towards. Here source moves away. So here just substitute VL equal to 0. Then here the direction changes, the minus becomes plus. So we get the formula. So N dash is equal to V by V plus VS times N. So just substitute. So N dash is equal to N by 2. So that N cancel. Then V by V plus VS. So we need that VS. So at what velocity the source moves away from the stationary listener when the frequency, that is apparent frequency, is half of the frequency created by the source. So that 1 by 2. So that 2 goes here, that V plus VS goes here. So V plus VS equal to 2V. So VS equal to, so the V goes, so that minus V. So 2 minus 1, 1. So velocity of the source is equal to velocity of sound. So at velocity of sound, we know that velocity of sound, so at 330 meter per second speed, when the source moves away from the stationary listener, the frequency heard by the listener is half of the frequency created by the source. Then so here that listener is at rest, source moves towards. So here that N dash is equal to V plus VL. So here listener is at rest, so V. Then source is moves towards here, so minus. So V minus VS by times that frequency N. When listener is at rest, source moves towards. If same case, listener is at rest, source moves away, then what is the formula? N dash is equal to V by, so here that VL equal to 0 for both the cases. So that is a problem number 2. So that source moves away, so the direction changes, so it's V plus VS. We can derive the formula easily from the basic. So both source and listener moves towards the from one another, that is N dash is equal to V plus VL by V minus VS times N. So N dash is the apparent frequency, this frequency heard by the listener. So N is the frequency created by the source. So V is the